Eşhedü enna Muhammeden Resulullah.
And I figure, okay, I'm gonna fire some shots.
Hayya alas-salah.
And they're gonna hear him on the camera.
Hayya alas-salah.
And if there's any extremists in there, they'll take notice. On Friday the 13th, 2015, my wife and I went out to a concert, and that was happened to be the night of the Paris attacks. And I came home, and when I pulled up in the car and stopped, when I got out, I looked over at the mosque between my properties right next door. And I was like, oh yeah, the Paris attacks. I was like, okay, what am I gonna do about this? So in my drunken stupidity, I decided I was gonna fire some shots.
It was Sunday when we came for prayers. Some of our members noticed the dramatic bullet wounds that were coming from inside of the sanctuary, the mosque. The innate reaction was, what did we do wrong? So one of the bullet wounds was right here, and one made it right through where the imam stands, the leader of the prayer. So even if I was at this level, it still would have been in the line of fire. My head would have been in the line of fire.
Probably the progression that led me to actually picking up the rifle, it was a slow process. A lot of it was, I was going over my Facebook post. I looked back at the post and I was kind of embarrassed by him. I was like, wow, it was an extreme amount of hatred that was for nothing. I said to myself, well, how did it get there? And a lot of it was from just social media. They would take quotes from the Quran that were, I later learned to believe were incorrect. So I had a complete misunderstanding of Islam.
The Quran says, seek help through patience and prayer. So that's what we did. We didn't let it scare us. We didn't let anybody scare us from practicing our faith and coming back to the mosque. And that was one of the biggest messages we wanted to send out initially. We had also wanted to meet Ted. All he had to do was come over to our mosque after we found out who it was. First thing that happens when he walks in, this big husky guy, muscular guy.
When I went in the meeting, I just remember thinking it was just, it had an overwhelming guilt.
You can feel the remorse. You can feel the regret that he had.
And what was the surprising thing is both sides were overwhelmingly surprised at the other side's sincerity.
And we said, you know, by the way, we're having this interfaith gathering on the true message of Islam and how to counter the extremist narrative. You can come there. Most of our congregation will be there, and that will be a perfect opportunity for you to apologize to the congregation.
It's been a tough time. I want to just apologize to everybody. If I had spent 5 minutes with you, it would have been all the difference in the world, and I didn't do that. I just ask for your forgiveness. Thank you.
They were all coming up, hugging me, shaking my hand, thanking me for the apology, and that was just overwhelming.
I would say life for the both of us is as brothers. He's not converted to Islam, but he's committed to spreading the real message to help educate people and enlighten them that everything is not what it seems.